Aki Kareem, British boxers. We're over here at Robert Rimmer's Phoenix camp. We've got Kid Dynamite, Mark Heffron, in the house. Not many people call you Kid Dynamite anymore, do they?
No, not anymore, not really now. Last two fights got in the distance, and so this next one I have to get the Dynamite back out.
That's it, mate. Well, you've got a chance to get the Dynamite back out October the 12th.
Yeah.
You're on Josh Warrington's undercard.
Yeah.
Against a man called, I do know his name, it's just, it's quite hard to pronounce. It's Rui Manuel Pavanito.
Yeah.
Who's, I believe he's fought Martin Murray, hasn't he?
Yeah, he boxed Martin Murray's last fight. Good, tough, durable opponents, what I need. Probably what I could have done with him before the Williams fight, really. A tough, durable guy like that, but it's a good experience fight for me. Looking forward to it.
He's only been stopped once.
Yeah.
The records and statistics show he should be taking you the 6 rounds.
Yeah.
But as we know, you sometimes like to go out fast on the tracks, let's say.
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, the stoppage comes, but I've trained for a good solid 6 rounds, so just going to get in there and just show my skills, yeah.
Have you been working on anything different, since the Williams fight? Have you been really sort of looking at different technical stuff? What have you been doing differently?
Been working on my boxing, really, get on the jab and stuff, yeah. And just being an all-round fighter, innit?
Well, the thing with you is one thing you'll never not have to worry about is the power. We know you've got that, but I remember when I used to watch you was really quite technical and you had a really elusive defence.
Yeah.
Are we looking to get a bit more back to that as well?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I'm just gonna get in there, just box him. Obviously, I'm gonna put on him a bit as well, innit? Do you know what I mean? I'm gonna have a bit of a fight with him.
Now, of course, you're always known for bringing a lot of fans down to wherever it is, but you do bring a lot down to Leeds, so are you bringing a few down this time as well?
Yeah, definitely put about 200-300 tickets for this one. Yeah.
Nice. Now, I know that there was talk of a title shot of some variety down the line. Do you know any more about this yet?
Well, there was talks of Andrew Robinson again. I heard that Liam Williams was vacating the British, and then I'd become like manager for the belt, but I've heard that Williams is not now. He's defending it in Cardiff, so still don't know what's happening. Just gonna focus on this next fight, get a good win, and then see what happens in the next 6 months. I'd want to be British champion.
Yeah,
definitely. I want to be fighting for the British title in the next 6 months. Felix Cash has got the Commonwealth as well, do you know what I mean? That's another option. That's what I want. I want the British and the Commonwealth.
How do you see the fight going with Felix Cash and Jack Cullen?
I think it's a good 50-50 fight. I literally don't have a clue, mate. It's 50-50.
But you'd be open to fighting the winner?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, if it was to be Jack Cullen, for example, somebody you know quite well, you've been around the same scene together for years now.
Yeah.
Would you look forward to a fight with Jack as well?
Yeah, definitely. I've done some good rounds sparring with Jack. Both helped each other out before. It'd be a good fight.
One of the best bars I've ever seen, actually, was you and Jack Cullen.
Yeah.
So I'd be excited about that one. The other name that's floating around at the minute in terms of that British middleweight title is Marcus Morrison.
Yeah.
Is that a fight as well you'd be open to?
Another good Manchester fight, isn't it? Yeah, it's a fight. I'd love that, yeah. I'd take that fight tomorrow. The fight got offered to me.
Yeah, and again, you know each other well as well. You both got, in terms of you've been around the same scene for a while together. Both got respect for each other as well. So these are the sort of Manchester fights
definitely.
That could be made, couldn't they?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Yeah. Family life, mate. What people don't see is that you are a bit of a family man. How old's Poppy now?
She's two now, yeah.
But, it seems to me that since you had Poppy, you have changed a little bit as well.
Yeah, definitely. She's chilled me out now, hasn't it? When I finish training, she's just on my mind all the time. Just want to get home and chill out with her. And obviously Rebecca as well.
Does that help you getting through camps and preparing for fights, and does that give you a different focus?
Yeah, it makes me work harder, yeah.
Definitely. Yeah, man. All right, give us a quick prediction for Saturday night, mate. Give us a quick prediction for October the 12th, mate.
Me? For me?
Yeah, for you, man.
Knockout, man. Definitely a knockout. Definitely.
Whilst we're on that note, your ex-stable mates, Lyndon Arthur and Zelfa Brown Fassbarrett are in action. Lyndon fighting for his first title, Commonwealth
first
title.
Yeah.
And Zelfa defending against Jordan McCrory, that's it.
Yeah. I've not really seen much of Zelfa's opponent and not seen Lyndon's, but I'm sure they'll both get the wins.
Yeah. Alright, mate. Good to catch up with you as always.
You too.
Nice yellow t-shirt. And see you soon, mate.
Thank you, mate.